What's up? What's good? It's AP, so welcome back to another Tutorial Bite. So today I'll be discussing on how I do these glitch effects or the RGB separation or the CMYK separation with my photos. I've been consistently doing this with my videos, but today I'll be trying it with my photos using Photoshop. So by the way, the photo that I will be using here is already processed via Lightroom and is featuring Abby Lau, so make sure to check out her Instagram, alright? So here you go, this is already processed, and now let's do it. So first and foremost, select the layer and duplicate it, and then you are going to this tab right here, images, and then go to adjustments, and then turn it black and white. Make some adjustments if you want, but you know, this is already gonna work. Next thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna double click that layer, and then in the blending options, you just have to select R, so you can make this layer right here red or magenta or whatever you wanna call it, or just play with the colors if you want. And then duplicate the layer, do the same thing, and now just turn on G and B, which is green and blue, and it will make a cyan layer. Now after doing that, you have to select the layer, just press Ctrl T so you can move it, you know, in some direction that you can make that separation and make it more visible. That is one of many ways that you can do that color separation or channel separation. So here's another way that I do it. First, I start off again and then right-click the layer, and then you'll be able to select this warp option. So you can warp it to a direction that you want, a curved one, not just in a direction, in a one-way direction or something like that. And now, all you have to do is just, you know, bend it or warp it to your desired position or something like that. It really depends. So what I do is I add another layer, I duplicate it, I just toggle off all the options, and now I just merge the cyan and the magenta layers, and now I can just erase some parts that you don't want to be glitched, and that will show up the layer under, which is not toggled with cyan or magenta. So there you go. And also crop it in a really cool way so you don't have those really weird red and cyan edges. So there you go. I hope you guys like it, and make sure to check out more of my tutorials in the coming days, and yeah, that's all. Peace out.